This is TK Coleman, and you are tuning in to another episode of TK's Two Cents. Today, we're going to talk about finding the work that gives back. Let's dive right in with the first tweet. If you wait until you have energy to do the things that give you energy, you'll continue to be drained by the things that make you feel dead inside. One of my favorite quotes says, a champion is someone who is willing to do what he hates in order to create what he loves. We all understand the importance of trade-offs in life. There are things that we want to have, but there must be other things we are willing to do in order to acquire those things. And so in the course of living life, we often find ourselves in the midst of a balancing act where we have our goals, we have our dreams, we have our ideals, the things we are striving towards, but then we have our responsibilities, our commitments, not necessarily things that other people are making us do, but things that might not bring us immediate gratification or short-term joy, but things that we do in spite of the discomfort involved for the sake of helping ourselves attain freedom over the long haul. This is an important balancing act to take on because life is designed in such a way that we can't just snap our fingers like a magician and instantaneously manifest the things that we want. It takes work. As Thomas Sowell said, there are no solutions. There are only trade-offs. So whenever we have a goal that we want to achieve, we have to ask ourselves, what are the trade-offs I am willing to make? What are the sacrifices I am willing to take on in order to make those things happen? Here's the problem, though. When you live your life in that way, it can be easy to only think about your dreams, to only think about the things that make you come alive as if they belong far out into the future, and as if the present moment is all about responsibility, all about hard work, and all about sacrifice. And so you live your life as if, okay, one day I'll be free, one day I'll experience joy, but today I just have to show up and it's going to be all pain. And that's no way to live, because there is a work that pays the bills and helps you to survive, but there is also a work that heals, a work that nourishes the soul, a work that fuels you, a work that makes you capable of doing even more work, a work that makes you come so deeply alive that your energy becomes infectious and inspiring to the people that are around you. And if you delay that work for the future, when you have time, when you've created a sufficient amount of freedom to do it, you compromise the very thing that is capable of making you great right now. Your job is to find the work that gives your energy back and to figure out ways to begin doing that work now, even if you are not as free as you want to be, to go all in on it. You don't have to have the freedom to do something full time in order to begin making it a priority in your life. Making something a priority isn't about doing it every minute of every day. It's about putting it first before everything else, even if that means you have to find a little extra time by getting up early in the morning to set aside 10 to 15 minutes to do that thing that gives you joy. Whatever your dream is, whatever your goal is, whatever your ideal job is, you absolutely cannot afford to wait until it becomes easy for you to only think about that thing. You've got to create some space in your life for that right now, because it is only by doing the work that makes you come alive that you will become alive enough to create more opportunities to do that work. Whatever you do, don't make your life only and entirely about survival and creating freedom for the future. Find a way to give yourself freedom right now, because it's only by capitalizing on the little opportunities to experience freedom today that you will develop the creativity and the inspiration to create more and more freedom as your life goes on. Let's go to tweet number two. We do not create because we know that our ideas will live on. We create because creativity is part and parcel of what it means to be fully alive. There's a saying that has become quite popular in recent times, and I understand the sentiments behind the saying. I know that the intentions are good, but it's a statement that I take issue with, and that statement is, be on the right side of history. The problem that I have with this idea of being on the right side of history is that it completely overlooks the fact that the people who exist in the future will have the power to define what history meant for themselves. And you can spend your entire life doing what you think are all amazing things that will put you on the right side of history. And two generations from now, the people who live in the future can look at your entire body of work and say, cancel this person. We don't read their books. We don't watch their shows. We don't consume their art. And there's nothing that you can do to control that. So there is nothing that you can do to guarantee yourself that you are ever going to be on the right side of history, because that's not your position to determine. You can decide what you think of the people who lived before you, but the people who come after you will decide what they think about you and your work. But here's what you can do. You can control your willingness to live a life of conviction, your willingness to orient your choices not around what you believe will work, what you believe will make you loved, but around what you actually think is true and what you actually think is worth doing. Now, I'm not disparaging the value of being pragmatic and thinking about what will work. If you're in business, you have to hold yourself accountable to what actually satisfies your customers. But even then, you're not putting that out into the future. You're focusing on things that you can measure right now. You're not making investments because you have some sort of guarantee that it will work 10 years. You're making investments because you're holding yourself accountable to measurable standards of progress that exist today and in the near future. That is what you have to do in order to be creative. Being creative isn't about a life that has guarantees. It's about recognizing that I am my best self when I am showing respect for my creative ideas, when I am living from my core, acting on my convictions, and bringing a sense of imagination and artistry to everything that I do. If you fail to do that, your soul will begin to die. You will feel less and less human, more and more mechanical in everything that you do. And unfortunately, you'll become more and more mediocre and easier to compete with and easier to replace in all of your everyday tasks. But on the other hand, when you say, I'm going to show up for my creativity, even though I have no promises that I'm going to be rich because of it, that my ideas will be appreciated by the next generation, that creativity will not only bring more joy to you now, but it will cause you to have a greater impact on the people that are around you in your lifetime. And that's all you can control. We create because of who God says we are, not because of what the world promises to give us in return. And when you create from that basis, you find far more joy and far more impact. That's how you find the work that gives back. And that's how you do that work. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. If you are listening on the podcast, be sure to subscribe. Feel free to leave a review or any comments that you have about things you'd like to hear me discuss in the future. If you're watching on YouTube, please be sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, share this with a family member or friend, or leave any questions or comments that you have in the comments section. I never take your time and attention for granted. Thanks for tuning in. It's always a pleasure. Keep supporting TK's Two Cents and keep focusing on the work that gives your energy back. Peace.